Today I am going to discuss a new chapter, Profit and Loss and Unitary Method. Today's topic is on profit and loss. So let us come to know what do we mean by profit and loss. Let us take an example. Suppose you buy a pen for rupees 30. You buy it for rupees 30 and then sold it to your friend. You sold this pen to your friend by rupees 35. So definitely you are getting here extra 5 rupees from your friend. So you are getting an extra 5 rupees. That 5 rupees is your profit. This is your profit. So whenever you are whenever you buy a things in a low price and sell it at a high price, you are making a profit, and the extra money you are getting, this is the profit value. Such as here the profit value is rupees 5. Again, the same thing, if you buy the pen for rupees 30 and after using sometimes you sold it to your friend by rupees 25. By rupees 25, you are selling it to your friend. Then, here you are losing for rupees 5. Here is the case of loss. Now what is 30 rupees and 35 rupees here? Here in the first case, this rupees, the rupees 30 here, this is the cost price. That means cost price is the price value by which you are buying a thing or someone is buying a thing. And this rupees 35 is called selling price. So selling price is the price value by which the things is sold, and the extra money is profit. If there is selling price higher than the cost price, then there is a profit. If the selling price in the second case, this is the cost price and this is the selling price. So obviously here selling price is less than the cost price, so you are making a loss. So this case is for loss. So we get an idea that whenever selling price we write it in short form SP is greater than cost price, we write it CP. Whenever SP, selling price, is greater than CP, then profit. Then there is a profit. If selling price SP is less than cost price, CP, then it is the case of loss. Then loss. And the profit and loss you are getting by subtracting the larger subtracting the smaller value from the larger value. So in profit case, in case of profit, this is SP minus CP. In case of loss, this is CP minus SP. So these two things we can take as your formula to find profit or loss. Now let us come to exercise 9A. In exercise 9A, from A number you have to calculate either profit or loss 3 number. Here is given cost price equal to rupees, this one, and selling price equal to rupees 2000. You have to find profit or loss whatever is here. So first we have to check correctly, is it a profit case or loss case? Check it. Cost price, that is CP, is 1685 and selling price ASP is 2000. So selling price is obviously greater than cost price. So we can write SP is greater than CP. So there is a case of profit. What will be the profit? The larger value SP, my smaller value CP. What is SP? Rupees 2000 and CP, rupees 1685. Subtract it. By subtracting, we get here 5 1 8 9 1, again 1 carry 6 1 7 3, rupees 315. This is the profit value. So this complete. So in that case we get profit, as here SP is greater than CP, so there is a profit. Now taking problem number 5, here I am just writing here CP. Okay, cost price CP is given rupees 10,510 and SP selling price is given rupees 8,610. So these are the CP and SP. Now check which one is larger. Here CP is 10,510 and SP is rupees 8,610. So obviously CP is greater than SP. So in that case there is a loss. Now you have to calculate the loss, just larger value minus smaller value, that is CP minus SP. Now what is CP? That is 10,510 minus SP 8,610. Subtract. By subtracting you are getting here 1900. 15 minus 6, 9, 1 carries 8 plus 1, 9, yes, 1900 is the loss. So in that case, there is a loss of rupees 1900. So this is the answer. Now I have taken a word problem from the same exercise, B number. Here is the problem written. Student buys a pen for rupees 25.50 and sell it for rupees 30.00. Find his profit or loss. You have to calculate either profit or loss, whatever is here. So check. First we have to note down what are the given things here. Here it is given that buy a pen for rupees this. So this is the cost price. So CP equal to rupees 25.50, and SP selling price. What is the selling price given? Sell it for rupees 30. So rupees 30.00. Now check which one is larger. Here SP is greater than CP. So the case is for profit. Now you have to calculate the profit. Profit equal to SP minus CP. What is SP? 30.00 and CP 25.50. Now subtract and find your answer. Let us subtract it at the side. From 30.00 we have to subtract below the decimal. Here is 50, on that side 25. Subtract it. 0 means 10 minus 5, 5. 1 borrowed from here. 10 minus 6, 4. 1 borrowed here, 4. Only 4.50. So rupees 4.50. So this profit has made here. This one is the answer. Okay. Now coming to another word problem, which is E number. Question is written here. A shopkeeper bought an almira for rupees 4,800. He spent rupees 100 on transporting it to his shop. He sold it for rupees 5,500. What was his profit? So what are the things we have to first note down? Shopkeeper bought an almira for rupees this. So this is the value of almira cost. So let us write almira cost rupees 4,800, but he spent an extra rupees 100 for transporting. So this is an extra expenditure, we can say it is an extra expenditure, rupees 100. So the shopkeeper is giving 4,800 and also 100 to get the almira in total. So here is the CP, cost price. Then what will be the actual cost price value? This 4,800 plus 100 rupees extra. Rupees 4,800 plus rupees 100 extra. Now add these two, you get rupees 4,900. This is the CP of the almira. Now what is given another thing? He sold it for rupees 5,500. So this is the selling price. So here is SP, rupees 5,500. Now check, CP is here 4,900, SP is here 5,500. Which one is larger? SP is greater than CP. SP is greater than CP, so there is a profit. Now what will be the profit value? This is the SP minus CP. What is the SP? Rupees 5,500 and CP is rupees 4,900. Subtract it, you get 600 rupees. Rupees 600. So this is the profit. So what was his profit? His profit was rupees 600. So this completes the answer. Now coming to another word problem, I have taken F number. Here is the question. Nikita bought 40 kilograms of tomatoes at the rate of rupees 8 per kg. Rate rupees 8 per kg and quantity of tomato is 40 kilogram. 5 kg of rotten tomatoes were thrown away. Then 5 kg tomatoes are rotten and these are thrown. She sold the rest of the tomatoes at the rate of rupees 10 per kg. Rest of the tomatoes he sold at rupees 10 per kg. How much profit did she get? You have to calculate the profit. So first thing, that tomatoes quantity is 40 kilogram. He bought it at the rate of rupees 8 per kg. So 1 kg tomatoes cost rupees 8. 40 kg tomatoes cost, you have to find first. Let us find. 40 kilogram or 40 kg tomatoes cost. 1 kg is cost rupees 8, 40 kg is cost rupees 8 into 40, multiply. So rupees 8 4 is 32, 320. This is the cost. So this is the CP or cost price, because C is buying these tomatoes by rupees 320. So this is the cost price. Now 5 kg of rotten tomatoes were thrown. 5 kg was rotten, so the remaining tomato we have to calculate. So let us write 5 kg tomatoes rotten. Therefore, tomatoes remains 40 kg minus 5 kg. This is the 35 kg. So now she has 35 kg. Now there is a rate given by which she is selling it. At the rate of rupees 10 per kg. That means 1 kg is cost rupees 10. She has available 35 kg tomato. So what is the cost value? This find out. 35 kg tomatoes cost. Rupees 10 per kg. Quantity 35. So rupees 10 into 35. So rupees 350. So this is the selling price. He sells it by this rupees. Now this is the selling price 350 and cost price is rupees 320. Check which one is larger. SP is greater than CP. So here SP is greater than CP. So the case is for a profit. Therefore profit equal to SP minus CP. What is the SP value? Rupees 350 minus CP value rupees 320. Subtract, we get rupees 30. So this is the profit value. So how much profit did she get? Therefore she get a profit of rupees 30. So this completes the problem. Now let us come to another topic on calculating selling price and cost price. Calculating SP and CP, the calculating of SP and CP. But in that case, one of the thing of either of CP or SP should be given and profit or loss should be given. How? Suppose you are given CP. CP is given and also there is a profit. This profit also given. Now, what will be the SP you have to find out. Okay, suppose CP is given rupees 300 and profit also given rupees 20. You have to calculate SP. Now recall the relation between SP CP in case of profit. We know in case of profit SP is greater than CP. In case of profit, SP is greater than CP. So you have to now calculate the SP which is greater than this 300 value. So you have to increase the value from CP. And how much it will increase? It is increased by the profit value rupees 20. So SP become 300 and plus 20 because SP should be greater than CP. So SP equal to CP plus increment profit. So in that case SP equal to CP plus profit. When SP is given and profit is given, CP is given and profit is given, SP equal to CP plus profit. CP is rupees 300 and profit is rupees 20. So we get SP rupees 320. So in that case SP become CP plus profit. Now if there is a loss case, suppose CP is given and there is a loss. In loss case we know SP is less than CP or CP is greater than SP. So in that case whenever you have to find the CP, SP. So SP should be decreased from CP. So in that case CP minus loss. So we get when there is a profit. Let us in case of profit, if we have to find the SP, in case of profit we know SP is greater than CP. So in that case SP is greater than CP, so CP plus profit. But if you have to find the CP, then CP equal to SP minus profit because CP is less than SP. Okay, but when there is a loss, in that case SP equal to, in case of loss SP is less than CP. So SP should be decreased from CP. So CP minus loss. In In case of loss, SP less than CP. So SP equal to CP minus loss. And to find CP, CP equal to CP is greater than SP. So CP equal to SP plus loss. So we get these things for loss and these things for profit. Okay. Now we are coming to our next exercise 9B. I have taken a problem from exercise 9B, one number. Here is the question. Sunil got a profit of rupees 450. This is the profit of rupees 450 by selling some article for rupees this. So selling it, that means this is the selling price. Find the cost price. You have to calculate the cost price. Now what are the given things? First note down. Here is profit rupees 450 and also given selling price. SP is given. What is the selling price? Rupees 2250. This is the selling price. You have to calculate CP. Calculate CP equal to what? Now in case of profit, we know SP is greater than CP. That means CP should be decreased from SP. CP is less than SP. So CP should be decreased from SP. So that is why there will be subtraction. So CP equal to SP minus profit. What is SP? Rupees 2250 minus profit is rupees 450. Calculate it. You get rupees. There is 1800. This is the CP value or cost price. So the cost price of the article. The cost price of the article is rupees 1800. So this completes the answer. So in that case, as there is a profit and SP is also given, but CP should be less than SP. So that is why CP equal to SP minus profit. Now coming to the next problem, two number. Here is my question, two number. Mukul incurs a loss of rupees 100. So loss of rupees 100. This is the loss case by rupees 100. This is the loss rupees 100. And selling a table for rupees 800. Selling price also given and loss is given. So note down it. Loss equal to rupees 100 and selling price rupees 800. Let's CP. Now recall the things, relation between CP and SP for loss case. In loss case, SP is less than CP. In case of loss, SP is less than CP. So CP is greater than SP, we can say. That means to calculate CP, you have to increase the value. So that is why CP equal to SP plus loss. Calculate it. What is the SP value? Rupees 800 and loss rupees 100. So you get CP equal to rupees 900. Therefore find the cost price of the table. In that case, therefore cost price of the table is rupees 900. So this completes the answer. As there is a loss case, you have to calculate CP. CP is greater than SP. So in that case, SP plus loss, you get CP. Now, coming to another problem number 4. Here is the question. A dealer bought an Almira for rupees 4,800. He spent rupees 75 to bring it to his shop. So this is an extra charge. He bought the Almira for rupees 4,880 and there is an extra charge 75 to bring it to his shop. Later he sold it at a loss of rupees 150. So rupees 150 is loss. Find the selling price. You have to calculate the SP, selling price of the Almira. What are the things here? Note down first. Almira cost. Rupees 4,880 and extra charge. Why extra charge? To bring the Almira to his shop, rupees 75 extra charge. So he total spent rupees 4,880 and 75 plus. This rupees he totally spent for the Almira. So this is the selling cost price or CP of the Almira. So CP is here rupees 4,880 plus rupees 75. To buy his Almira, he totally spent this rupees. So this is the CP. This become 8 plus 7, 15,518,9, 4,955. So this is the CP. Now here is a loss case. He has made loss of rupees 150. So CP is given 4,955. Here is a loss of rupees 150. You have to calculate SP. In case of loss, we know SP is less than CP. You have to calculate SP. So value should be decreased from CP. So that is why SP equal to CP minus loss. Because value should be decreased, so subtract. CP is rupees 4,955 and loss is rupees 150. Subtracting we get rupees, subtract 5 minus 5 0, 9 minus 1 8, 4,805. This rupees is the selling price. So now write your answer. What is the selling price of the Almira? The selling price. Therefore, the selling price of the Almira is rupees 4,805. This completes the answer. Now, another problem from this exercise, 8 number I have taken. Problem number 8. What is the question here? A shopkeeper buys 10 pairs of shoes for rupees 180 each. Quantity of shoes is 10 pairs and rate is rupees 180 for each pair of shoe. He makes a profit of rupees 200 by selling it. Profit of rupees 200. He make profit of rupees 200. At what price did she sell it? That means you have to calculate the selling price. But selling price for each pair, one pair. Now, first we will calculate the selling price of whole pairs of shoes. That means 10 pairs of shoes. let us note down the things. 10 pairs of shoes, what is the cost we have to find? Each pair of shoes cost rupees 180. Let us write. Each pair of shoes cost rupees 180. So therefore, 10 pairs of shoes cost. This become rupees 180 into 10. Multiplying, we get rupees 1800. So this is the CP. We can say this is the CP for or of CP. Let us write CP for cost price for 10 pairs of shoes. CP for 10 pairs of shoes equal to rupees 1800. But the case is a profit of rupees 200 overall. And profit rupees 200. You have to calculate selling price or SP. First we will calculate SP for 10 pairs. So let us calculate. Here is CP given, profit is given. In case of profit, we know SP is greater than CP. So value should be increased to find SP. So SP equal to CP plus profit. So let us calculate it. SP equal to CP plus profit. What is CP? 1800, and profit is rupees 200. By adding, we get 2000. So this is the SP, but this SP is for 10 pairs of shoes. Therefore, 10 pairs of shoes selling price SP of SP of 10 pairs of shoes equal to rupees 2000. You have to calculate SP for each pair of shoes. Therefore, SP of each pair of shoes. This you will get by dividing 2000 by 10. So rupees 2000 divided by 10. This becomes rupees 200. So selling price of each pair of shoes become rupees 200. So let us write the answer. Therefore, the selling price of each pair of shoes is rupees 200. This completes the answer. So students, this was the topic on cost price, selling price, profit and loss. Next day or in my next class, we will discuss another topic. Thank you and goodbye.